The 45,000-ton Vikrant got the prefix INS, Indian Naval Ship, at a formal commissioning ceremony attended by Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on the 2nd of September. Vikrant, which cost about $2.5 billion, or 2.1 billion pounds, was expected to be inducted into the Navy by 2017, but due to issues, this got delayed. The locally designed and built warship is India's newest and most powerful platform. The ship is so massive that it can house two Olympic pools and two football fields inside it. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how good is India's newest aircraft carrier, INS Vikrant. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft or ship, and 3 days of premium account. Vikrant is designed by India's Directorate of Naval Design of the Indian Navy and is the first warship to be built by Cochin Shipyard. Its construction involved the participation of a large number of private and public firms. Around 76% of the ship's parts were sourced indigenously. About 500 Indian firms were roped in. It's named Vikrant as a tribute to India's first aircraft carrier, INS Vikrant, from 1961. The name Vikrant means courageous in Sanskrit. Significant delays haunted the Vikrant. Its keel was laid down in 2009, and the carrier is 13 years in the making. INS Vikrant is 262 meters, or 860 feet in length, has 2,300 compartments, and can accommodate 1,700 seamen. Vikrant has a hospital complex, cabins for female officers, two football field-sized flight decks, 8 kilometers or 5 miles of corridors, and 8 generators capable of lighting up a city of 2 million people. Powered by 4 General Electric LM2500+ gas turbine, it can reach a top speed of 52 kilometers per hour, or 32 miles per hour, and has an endurance of 13,900 kilometers, or 8,600 miles. Sensor suite includes ELTA ELM2248 MF Star AESA multifunction radar and CELEX RAN 40L 3D L-band air surveillance radar. DRDO Shakti EW suite is present for electronic warfare and decoys. The Vikrant features a stowbar, short takeoff but arrested recovery configuration with a ski jump. The deck is designed to enable aircraft such as the MiG-29K to operate from the carrier. It's expected to carry an air group of up to 30 aircraft, which will include up to 24 to 26 fixed-wing combat aircraft, primarily the MiG-29K, besides carrying 10 Kamov Ka-31 or Westland Sea King helicopters. The Mikoyan MiG-29, NATO reporting name Fulcrum, is a twin-engine jet fighter aircraft designed in the Soviet Union. It was developed by the Mikoyan Design Bureau as an air superiority fighter during the 1970s. While originally oriented towards combat against any enemy aircraft, many MiG-29s have been furnished as multi-role fighters capable of performing a number of different operations, and are commonly outfitted to use a range of air-to-surface armaments and precision munitions. The MiG-29 has been manufactured in several major variants, including the multi-role MiG-29M and navalized MiG-29K. Well, initially, INS Vikrant will have MiG-29K. India is planning to move towards a different fighter since there are lots of reliability issues. Indian Navy Chief Vice Admiral S.N. Gourmade said, "We designed the Vikrant for operating the MiG-29K, but we would ultimately deploy the indigenous TEDBF, twin-engine deck-based fighter aircraft, for which we're working with DRDO. For the interim, we're looking at Rafale and FA-18 aircraft, and trials have been carried out." As per the Indian Navy official, evaluation is being done to select the aircraft, and we hope that the decision will be taken earliest. The KA-31 will fulfill the Airborne Early Warning, AEW, role, and the Sea King will provide anti-submarine warfare, ASW, capability. The primary air defense weapon of INS Vikrant is the Barak 8. Barak 8, which has been jointly developed by India and Israel. This 90-kilometer or 56-miles range missile is designed from the start to intercept supersonic cruise missiles, which travel a few meters above the water, which makes it perfect for missile defense. The carrier is expected to have two 32-cell vertical launch system cells. A very important feature of Barak 8 is that the minimum engagement range is only 0.31 miles, or half a kilometer. So the system can target an incoming hostile object till the very last seconds, potentially giving it the ability to target it multiple times. This enables it to intercept missiles very close to the ship, and it performs the role of point defense SAM as well. The role of CIWS, close-in weapon system, is left to the 4 AK-630 six-barreled 30mm Gatling guns, which is a last-ditch defense against missiles. Aircraft carriers are the most visible symbol of contemporary naval power. With the latest INS Vikrant and INS Vikramaditya, India now has a two-carrier navy. There are plans for another new carrier, though they've not been approved yet. The platform with its air wing will be able to project power far beyond India's coastlines. INS Vikrant would strengthen India's position in the Indian Ocean region and its quest for a blue water navy. The locally designed and manufactured INS Vikrant highlights the abilities of a maturing military-industrial complex. Though it has several shortcomings, like no nuclear power, limiting its range and endurance, and the absence of catobar, catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery, it's still a good first build. The experience building and operating INS Vikrant will enable India to design more potent aircraft carriers in the future. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.